Hello and welcome to another live stream in the Law of Attraction and the Secret Facebook group. We're a community of more than 130,000 lifestyle designers here co-creating inside this Facebook group. And if you are watching this outside of the Facebook group, go to livemoreperfectdays.com/group to get access to this community of 130,000 people that are wanting to learn about the law of attraction and install it into their lives to really create their life by design. We use this term lifestyle designers as a way to get us to understand that we are creating our lives in every single moment. The purpose of this group is to bring us all together and to use these lifestyle design tools, including apps and technology, as well as the law of attraction, so that you can create the life that you truly want to live. Today, I want to share something which is at the heart of manifestation. And the topic of today's live stream is how to own your desires and what's the importance of owning your desires. Why is it at the heart of manifestation? For many of us, manifestation starts with a desire. You start with this idea of wanting something first or not wanting something else. So the only reason why you would want to practice the law of attraction is because you desire something, you want to call something into your life. We were sent to this world to co-create with life, and we are going to, as long as we're alive, have ever-expanding desires. As soon as you've reached a goal or achieved something, the nature of the human experience is to want the next thing, to be going after it. This is the magic of life, and this is the magic of co-creating with life. And at the basis of manifestation is desire. So, why is it so important to be able to own our desires? Many of us live in a world where the idea of wanting something, wanting things, is somehow, in some ways, taboo. And it's based on various levels of complexity, depending on what it is that you choose to want. So I come from a relatively conservative world in South Africa, where, for example, nobody spoke openly about intimacy. So the idea that anybody could want or desire a lot of intimacy or many sexual experiences was not something that I had a space or that I felt comfortable to be able to own. So what happened there is I had the desire, but I was never really able to own it. And what happens is when you don't own a desire completely and you're not able to articulate it and speak it out, either it's not clear for yourself or it creates an inauthentic expression of yourself in the world. So what happens there is I have this desire to explore my sexual life force, but I don't have the ability to be able to own that desire and to be able to speak it clearly to the people that I connect with or to people that I just want to share my life with. So owning your desires is a really, really powerful, powerful part of the manifestation process. I'll give you another example quickly. For many people, we want to be rich, but we don't want people to know that we want to be rich. And inherently in that is a lack of authenticity. I want to take a step back. Maybe this makes sense to you, and for many people it does, because there's this programming that we have around money. Everybody wants to get more of it. The world where I came from in South Africa, everybody wanted it, everybody was chasing it, but nobody spoke directly about how much money you make, how much does your new job pay, how much have you got in the bank. Those were sort of off the record or taboo type topics. And so what happens there is you want more money, but you're not able to authentically own the desire to say, you know what, I'm Gareth and I believe that I'm worth $30,000 a month because this is what I'm doing, etc., etc., etc. And once you're able to own that desire, it's no longer for the other person to guess what they think that you want. And so this is really, really important. And I want to share a very quick story with you. And this can work with anything. But we were working with a student here in San Marcos in Guatemala. We were working with him in person and we were talking about this idea of being able to own your desires, to really be okay with wanting whatever it is that you want. And that's the important part. We can want whatever we want, but own it. Say that I'm Gareth and I am the person who wants $30,000 a month or $1 million or a new car or a new partner or lots of intimate partners or whatever that is. That desire is up to you and it's okay to want what you want, but it's more important that you own this desire. So this student of ours had walked past a girl once or twice in the town where we live, and he'd felt sort of an erotic connection fire up inside him the first few times that he saw this girl walking past one another. And then he was on Facebook a little while later, and he saw someone posting into the group, a Facebook group for our small community here, and he recognized her. So he sent her a direct message on Facebook and said, "Hey, I've seen you around town," and they sort of had a bit of a conversation once, but never quite got to know each other. And he said, "Hey, I've seen you around town, and I'd really love to go for a coffee with you." And afterwards, he thought about what we told him about owning his desires, and he actually sent another message and said, "Actually, what I really want is to see if we can get to know each other better, maybe go out for a drink, and if it flows this way, I actually really feel like I would love to run some erotic energy with you." This was his true desire, and it's not something that he'd been able to own before. And he pressed send, and he was really nervous, and he forgot about it. Or he didn't forget about it. He was probably checking his phone every 5 minutes. But the story goes that a couple of hours later, she receives the message, and she replies and says, "Hey, thank you so much. Nobody's ever been that direct and that open and honest with me. I think you're really great. Let's go for a drink and see where this goes." And they ended up having a beautiful connection together. But how often do we do that in our lives where we want something, but we're not able to speak directly into exactly what it is that we want? And when we do that, we're not owning our desire. We're not proud of the fact that I want money. I've got ever expanding desires to save the world or to whatever it is that you're desiring. To be able to own that is really, really powerful. And so those are some of the tools that we're teaching at Live More Perfect Days. Our core scaffolding program shows you exactly how to create a plan for your life called the My Perfect Day system. And it really is an opportunity for you to own your desires about how you want your life to look. And there's all these prompts. If you go to livemoreperfectdays.com/start, you can get access to this the system completely free. And it allows you to go through this process and own your desires about how you want your life to look in all areas. Your romantic connections, your work, your finances, your health, where you want to live, your home, all of these different things. We show you a process of exactly how to be able to own these desires. Once you start to own your desires and you know what you want, now you can start to use the law of attraction to bring these things into your world. So I've got two things I would like you to do right now. One of them is me owning my desire with you. My desire is to help a million people to install the My Perfect Day system into their lives and to live their life by design. And so my request for you is for you to share with me where you are on your lifestyle design journey. What are you stuck with? What are the things that are keeping you from living the life that you want? Where do you feel that you get in your own way? Where do you feel that you don't quite have the money that you want? I want you to write in the comments below this video anything that you feel you could use help with in order to get the law of attraction to work for you consistently. When I'm able to own my desire of what I'm asking you for, you now know exactly why I made this video. It's to impart some knowledge to get you to be able to own your desires. And for me, it's owning my desire for some information back from you. Because when I know what it is that you're looking for and what it is that I can help you with in order to start living your life by design, I can create content and programs, and my team can build a series of stories that are going to resonate to help you solve the problems that it is that you're having in getting the law of attraction to work in your life. And so when that starts to happen, our community starts to grow, financial abundance starts to flow for us, we're able to help more people start to live more authentically, they show up stronger in their lives, in your family, in your job, with your finances, and with your health, as you start to install these tools. So that's the first request. Write in the comments below here where you're getting stuck and what we can help you with to get the law of attraction working for you in your life consistently. Cool? If you've watched all the way through to this point in the video, I really hope that you will share exactly where you are on your journey. Let me know. Negative thoughts. I don't have the belief. The money's not showing up. Whatever those things are, write them in the comments below. That's the first request. The second request is for you to look in your life right now and find at least one area of your life that you haven't been able to own your desires, where you haven't been able to fully stand in your power and say, "This is what I want." Maybe you've been keeping it from somebody close to you. Maybe you've been keeping some story from family, friends, your community, because you think that maybe they won't get it. The invitation for you is to be able to stand in your power and to own your desires. You're allowed to want whatever you want. And as soon as we're able to do that and let go of whatever we think the implications of that are going to be, the more we can start living from a truly, truly empowered place, because now everybody around us knows what it is that we want. And what may happen is the people that don't agree with you may leave or disappear out of your life. And that is the biggest blessing in the world, because now you're really starting to live in your authenticity. And you can soon see that if people are not able to support you to get what you want, it doesn't make sense to keep on trying to make those connections fit. So stand in your power, own whatever it is that you want, and find one place in your life right now. And even if you just own it to yourself, amazing. If you can find a place in your life where you haven't been able to stand in your authenticity and own your desires with somebody else, whether it's your partner, your kids, your family, your friends, go and do that. Go to somebody and say, hey, I'm Gareth, and I am so sick of working in my job in Johannesburg 6 years ago that all I really want to do is just fucking sell it all and get on the road and go travel and just see what happens. That's what I really feel like doing. The moment I finally managed to own my desire and say exactly what I just said now, 6 years ago, my entire life changed. I moved into a different place. I was concerned that when I said this to people, friends and family, that they were going to say, oh, bad idea, bud, don't do that. And what happened? Those people were like, go for it, bro. You're at the stage of your life where you can do it, and they actually supported me. The people that truly love you want to see you happy, and they want to see you standing in your power. So find somewhere in your life where you're not able to own your desires and articulate it either to yourself by writing it down, add it as an order board item to your vision board, or go up to somebody that you really care about and say, hey, this is my truth, this is my desire, and I'm owning it. So my request is also for you to just share in the comments below this video what you're battling with regards to lifestyle design, creating a vision board, getting the law of attraction to work for you. Share those comments below this video, and we'll start creating content and programs that'll help to support you on your lifestyle design journey. Thank you so much for being part of this community. Thanks for those of you that are already part of our Live More Perfect Days community. If you're not yet, go to livemoreperfectdays.com/start and install the My Perfect Day system so that you can get clear about what your desires are for your life by creating your perfect day. Thank you so much. I'll see you next time. Ciao, ciao.